Welcome to the Doc2Help video tutorial series. Today, I'd like to take you on a quick tour of Doc2Help's interface. I think you will find it familiar and easy to use. Plus, Doc2Help provides a dynamic help pane, super tooltips, and all sorts of user assistance, including videos, to make your life easier. Doc2Help has four quadrants that all work together to make authoring and building your outputs quick and easy. They are the ribbons, accordion panes, windows, and dynamic help. Let's start with the ribbons. Doc2Help features Microsoft Office-style ribbons. The File, Home, Topics, and Project tabs are displayed by default. The Editor, Insert, and Table tabs appear only when you open a document in Doc2Help's built-in HTML5 Content Editor. Each ribbon is divided into logical ribbon groups, and many dialog boxes are opened directly from the ribbon groups using dialog box launchers. You can hover over any button to display its super tooltip. These tooltips are a great way to learn what a button will do without even clicking on it. Just a quick hint, in Doc2Help, you will use the Home ribbon often because that is where you choose and build your outputs. Choose what you want to build here and click here to build it. Next, let's look at the accordion panes. They are used to manage your documents, table of contents, index, and more. The Documents pane is where all of your project documents are organized. A project can contain as many documents as you like, and they could be Word or Content Editor documents. Your project can contain a single type of document or a mix of both types. Documents can be added to your project two ways. You can click the Add Existing Document button to import existing documents, or you can create a new document by choosing the Create New Document button. Change your mind? Documents can be rearranged in the Documents pane with the arrow keys. To open any document, just double-click on it. Word documents will open in Word, and Content Editor documents will open in Doc2Help. On to the Contents pane. Doc2Help builds your table of contents for you automatically, but you can customize it here by rearranging topics and adding topics from the Topics pane. If you want to roll back to your original table of contents, just click the Rebuild Table of Contents button. You can manage your index entries in the Index and Groups pane. If you'd like, you could add index keywords right here, or you can do it while writing your documents. The Related Topics pane makes it simple to manage See Also links in your online help. Doc2Help creates these links for you automatically, but you can add additional links by simply dragging them in from the Topics pane. Doc2Help's windows are the next section we will look at. The Start page contains shortcuts you can use to create and open projects, as well as open your most recent projects. This page also contains links to videos and documentation. You've already seen the Topics window. This is where you manage your topics. You can drag and drop them into the Contents, Index, and Related Topics panes, rearrange them, and customize the view to your liking. You can even edit in the Topics window. Context IDs for context-sensitive help can be added right here. The Outputs window is displayed when you click the Build button. It displays the progress of your build, and if there are any issues, such as broken links, they are displayed here. Double-click on an error message to quickly troubleshoot the problem. If you choose to use Doc2Help's built-in editor, each topic will open in its own window, and the Editor, Insert, and Table ribbons will open so that you can edit your documents. And now, the last quadrant. As you navigate the interface, the Dynamic Help pane will display relevant user assistance. After you have become comfortable in Doc2Help, you can turn Dynamic Help off by clicking here. If you develop help for software applications and are interested in adding Dynamic Help to your apps, you'll be happy to learn that when you buy Doc2Help, the Dynamic Help control is included for free. Dynamic Help is a .NET WinForms control. While we are here, there are two other icons you should know about. This icon opens the entire online help system for DocTeHelp. And this button opens the Getting Started wizard. The Getting Started wizard helps you create new projects in a few clicks, plus open existing projects and samples. It also includes handy links to additional user assistance. That's all for now, but there is so much more we could talk about, including collaboration with SharePoint, responsive output, and more. See the video page on DocTeHelp.com to check out our library of tutorial videos. To learn more and download a free trial, go to DocTeHelp.com. I'm Nicky Bleiel. Thanks for watching, and thanks for choosing DocTeHelp.